You're listening to Morning Edition from NPR News.
Support for DUQ comes from Range Resources, helping to reduce America's dependence on foreign energy through natural gas drilling in the Marcellus Shale. More information on the Marcellus Shale is at myrangeresources.com.
What a nice day. I know it's kind of dark and rainy. Traffic is so hideous. But listen to this. I'm boss to a beggar who can stay tuned for music that will even make a long, long day. We get started about 15 minutes from now.
That's right, Bob is talking about traffic being hideous, especially if you are on Route 28 southbound near Fox Chamber. We have reported an accident and police on the wounded said Chamber approaching Shadow Water to the 31st Street Bridge. 51 is slow approaching Stewart to Maytide and also turning approaching the Edge Road to Liberty Tunnel. West Liberty Jam approaching South Busway to Liberty Tunnel. Cranberry Township of Rochester Road in front of St. Ferdinand Church. Earlier accident is clear. The lawn incline is running out today. This update is provided by Nectech.
This report is a service of Sears Auto Center. Information on Sears Auto Center available at searsauto.com.
Pretty good news for today and into tomorrow, night of day 58. Right now, we have showers in 54 degrees in Pittsburgh. The 12th congressional race in Pennsylvania is actually two elections in one. Voters will select a candidate in a special election to serve out the term of the late John Murphy, and they'll also nominate a candidate to run term in the fall. The three candidates vying for John Murphy's seat are Republican Tim Burns, Democrat Mark Pritz, and Libertarian Dean Roe Boris. Burns and Pritz are being aided by a lot of money from their respective parties and outside interests. The Democratic Party wants to keep the seat that was held by Murphy since 1974, while the Republicans are trying to tap into voter discontent with the Obama administration policies. On the Saturday morning, I visited Burns' headquarters in Washington, PA. Congressman Aaron Sharp from Peoria, Illinois, showed up with a busload of Capitol Hill staffers to go door knocking with Burns. Volunteers were busy working the phones, doing voter surveys. How long do you have to go for the special
election? Do you vote all the time? And I was wondering if Tim Burns can come on your support.
I really think so.
Okay.
Burns, a conservative, has a business background.